You know, when it comes to serving others in the name of Jesus, using the resources that he provides, we can easily start to think, well, what about me? What about my needs? What about the things that I legitimately need in life? Well, in today's passage, Paul's going to answer that, and he's going to do it by showing us we have someone taking care of us who is better at taking care of us than we could ever be. Okay, as we look at this issue of caring for the interests of others before we care for the interests of ourselves, we can think that, you know, we're going to do without. Someone's going to take advantage of us. And Paul here in Philippians 2 uses Jesus as the example. And as he does, he brings about this observation that God himself, and you'll see it right here as we begin reading, God himself takes care of Jesus because Jesus was a servant. Let's read it. It says, therefore. Now remember that word therefore refers back to the things we've said before. And it was the example of Jesus leaving all of his divine heavenly rights behind as he stepped into human form and became a servant to us, being obedient to the point of death, you know, meeting our needs first. And God says, therefore, because he did all that, God has highly exalted him and bestowed on him the name that is above every name, so that at the name of Jesus, every knee should bow in heaven and on earth and under the earth, and every tongue confess that Jesus Christ is Lord to the glory of God the Father. So when it comes to our needs, who's on the line? Who is responsible for those? We often think it's us and think that we need to be watching out for our needs. But God says, if you concern yourself with serving others, and I'm going to change the color on this to say your responsibility is to serve others, then God makes it his responsibility to care for you. Very simply, isn't that what this is saying? In giving the example of what happened in Jesus' life, you see, God highly exalted him, bestowed on him a name that's above every name, so that at the name of Jesus, every knee would bow in heaven and earth, every tongue confess that Christ is Lord to the glory of God the Father. You see, our focus is not to be on our needs. Our focus is to be on serving others. And then God makes it his focus to care for us. You see, we don't need to be afraid when it comes to serving others. We have to look at Jesus' example. Now, in doing so, we need to be realistic, because what we find is Jesus was mistreated, wasn't he? Jesus was accused wrongly. Jesus was abused, beaten, hung on a cross. But he was willing to go there because he was eager to be obedient to the Father. And he was eager to be loving toward us, in service to us. You see, that is what Jesus was after when he came to the earth, was not his own benefit, but the benefit of others. And it goes all the way back to verse number 2, where we are told he had a mindset to serve others. Now, I understand this is pretty revolutionary. It's pretty countercultural, because we have a culture that tells us to keep proper boundaries and to take care of yourself so that you can then take care of others. And there is an element of truth to some of that. But that's not the way the Apostle Paul talks. The Apostle Paul says, we are to concern ourselves with being servants. And as we do, God concerns himself with caring for us. And really, there's no one who can take care of us better than God. There's no one who can be our nurturer and our caretaker like he can. So I think we have nothing to worry about here, really, because God is on our side. He has given us every resource we need to be the kind of people we need to be. And he will care for us as we make it our business to care for others. Jesus, teach us how to do this. Teach us how to push down and push away the fear and the anxiety that comes from thinking that our needs or our very legitimate needs are going to be neglected. Enable us to turn our eyes to you and to you, our Heavenly Father, that we will be confident in faith that you have promised us that you will care for our needs as we care for others. Lord, show us how to do that for the sake of Christian unity. In Jesus' name.